Hi guys, I'm Ram Agarwal. You are watching my channel 52 Pixels. Let's get started. Hi guys, in this tutorial we are going to see how to make images look little hand-drawn and make it look like a poster. So well, as you can see, this is the image and this is the normal image, and after applying some filters it looks somewhat like this, and it basically looks like hand-drawn, and it has that special effect of you know the colors and the noise of the colors. So same thing we are going to practice with this image in today's tutorial. So to get started, what we are going to do is just go to filter. Under filter we have something called as convert for smart filters. So after tapping on this one, what is going to happen is that it is just going to convert this main image into a smart object. So you can either right click here and then convert it to a smart object, or from here you can just convert it for smart filters. It's one and the same thing. Now once you have converted the image to a smart filter, what we can do is just go to filter gallery, and over here in filter gallery we have all these different options that we can work with. So starting with watercolor, so all of these effects are useful, but in this particular artistic tab we are going to go to watercolor effect, and under watercolor effect we get all these three sliders that we can use to work around with our image. So we can either work with the texture, so increasing the texture will increase the sharpness and the grunginess of the image. It won't look that good, so I'll make it 1, or you can keep it 0 as well, it's the same thing, it won't matter much. Shadow intensity, if you increase it to 10, it will just turn everything into black, so make sure that it is quite low, and by low I mean that it's all like almost near to 0 or 1. So depending upon your image and the requirement of your image, you can work around with that, but I guess shadow intensity 1 works well for this one. And this is the brush detail, so even that can be adjusted. So if the brush detail is 1, it looks very like it uses a finer brush and it looks very sharp, whereas if the brush detail is 14, it looks a little bloated, it doesn't look that good. So make sure you keep it halfway, or depending upon your image you can work around with that. So in this particular image I'll keep this brush detail as 7. And then there is something called as palette knife, you can find it over here. So using palette knife, you can again you get all these three controls, so you can increase or decrease the softness of your the filter basically. So I don't find softness to be much helpful for this particular image, so I'm going to keep it as low as possible, somewhat like 1. And stroke detail 3, so stroke detail is again the details of the stroke of the brush that is in use to create this particular effect. So it can be 1, 2, or 3. So I prefer keeping it at 3 because it gives that good transition between different colors. It makes it look like hand drawn. So if you see over here, as you can see over here, it gives that sharp details of the different colors, and it just looks, I don't know, it just looks very sharp. So we can definitely use this one. And stroke size, you can increase or decrease stroke size. As the stroke size decreases, the image looks little like this, it looks blurred and it doesn't look that good. And as the stroke size decreases, it looks very sharp and very unnatural, you can say. So remember that you can keep it around halfway and get the best results. And over here we have all these two options. So one was watercolor and one is palette knife. If you want to add one more, you can just tap on this plus icon and you can get all the effects, but I don't want this, so I can just delete this one and we can just work around with these two. So now that I'm done with selecting the filters, I can just click on OK, and as you can see the filters have been applied, but the original image is still intact, so I can just turn it on and off and keep my original image in the side. So that's the use of converting the image into a smart object. But more than that, what you can do now is that again go to filter. Under filter we have the option as noise, and under noise we have the option called as median. So using median you can just make the image look a little fluid. So basically using median you can make the image look a little fluid and a little distorted, So that's what I want to do. If you increase the median, the more the median is, the more distorted your image is going to be. So make sure that it's not too distorted. So radius 1 or radius 6 would work. I guess radius 6 is what we are going to keep. And once done, you can just click on OK. So we've got median as well. And then for the final thing, what we are going to do is again go to filter. Under filter, we have again go to noise, and in noise we have the option as add noise. So I want to give this image a little noise so that it looks like it has been worked upon a paper, because if the image is very you can say clear of noise, it would not look like it's been worked on a paper. But we want to give it the effect of paper a little bit. So if you add more noise, it is going to look like this, all grainy, and it doesn't look that good. And if you reduce the amount of noise, it's going to look this like this, smooth, or you know, not so natural kind of a portrait. So if you want to make it look like natural, keep it around let's say 4 or 5, so that it has all those grains, plus it doesn't look that bad as compared to other ones. You can even reduce the amount a little bit, because I don't know, I'm not happy with this one. So amount is 2 for noise, and once done, I can just click on OK, and I've got the noise. Now you can just turn this LED on and off, and you can see that changes. So this is the original image, and this is the portrait that we created. So it definitely looks like a portrait, and it looks very natural and has that fluid kind of a feel of a paint color. You can even work around with the position of all these different filters. So you can do one thing. You can just take median over here underneath the filter gallery, because median is not that necessary. It is just ruining that sharpness of the image. So as you can see, as soon as I take the median layer underneath the filter gallery layer, the median is getting applied, but it is looking very natural. It looks, now it looks more fluid and sharp. So once we are done with this one, what you can do is, just to add a little more stronger effect, what you can do is just add a new layer on top of this one. And with this layer selected, you can just pick a color from this image. So for picking the color, we are going to use this eyedropper tool. Tap on eyedropper tool and select a color to sample. So I'm going to sample this color and use a brush to plot some splashes on this particular image. So for getting the brush, you can just tap on this one, and under brushes we have all these brushes. So it is general brushes, dry media brushes, wet media brushes, special effect brush. So go to special effect brush, and under special effect brush we have all these options of different splatter brushes. We are going to use this one, and you can then work around with the size and everything. So may it be opacity, flow, or everything that you want to adjust. And you can just plot some points or, you know, brushes on the image, so that it looks, it gives that splatter effect of the paint, and it makes it look a little natural. So again, we are going to sample this time blue color, and again using the same brush, we are just going to plot some points somewhat like this. Now going to this layer one again, what you can do is go to filter, and under filter we have something called as blur. Under blur, go to Gaussian blur and make sure that you don't make it too much blurred, so that it looks very unnatural and edited. So we want them to be sharp, but again we want it to be a little fluid, so try to keep radius as low as possible. So I've kept the radius as 1.2. So once then you can just click on OK, and this is the final image that you got. So this is the before and this is the after. It definitely looks like a paint or a portrait that someone has created using his own creativity on a drawing sheet. And then you can just maybe bluff around with your friends saying that you have drawn this image. Well, that's it for today, guys. If you found the video to be helpful, please like the video. And in case of any queries or suggestions, please feel free to reach out to me through the comments. With that being said, it's me, Ram Agarwal, signing off for the day. See you in the next one. Thank you.